Starch chains are uniformly comprised of a single nutrient molecule, namely glucose. By comparison, protein chains are combinations of 20 chemically unique amino acids. This example shows a short chain consisting of 10 amino acids represented by differently colored spheres. Here is the basic structure of amino acids. All amino acids have both a carboxyl group and an amine group attached to the first carbon, designated as the alpha carbon. In addition, the alpha carbon also has chemically distinct side groups, indicated by the letter R, that contribute unique chemical properties to each amino acid, such as being acidic or basic, hydrophobic or hydrophilic, and neutral or charged. As shown here, R side groups can be simple, such as the hydrogen of glycine, or complex, like the aromatic rings of tryptophan. Amino acids link to each other with a peptide bond. Peptide bonds form when the carboxyl group of one amino acid nears the amine group of a second amino acid. The amine and carboxyl groups interact and undergo a condensation reaction that produces a molecule of water and the peptide bond. In this manner, amino acids form chains of polypeptides and proteins. If the chain is less than 50 amino acids, it is considered a peptide. If it is greater than 50 amino acids, it is a polypeptide, and proteins are comprised of one or more polypeptides. Amino acid chains are highly variable in size, but all start with a free carboxyl group called the C-terminus and end with a free amino group called the N-terminus. For simplicity, our illustration of digestion will focus on a peptide chain of 15 amino acids comprised of only the 10 essential amino acids, identified using colored balls to depict their R groups and labeled with their three-letter designation. Protein digestion occurs by two groups of enzymes, endoproteases and exopeptidases. Endoproteases cut amino acid chains within the chain to form numerous, shorter chains. The two most prevalent endoproteases for insect digestion are similar to the vertebrate serine endoproteases, trypsin and chymotrypsin. Trypsin-like endoproteases break peptide bonds when the carboxyl group in the bond is one of the basic amino acids, lysine or arginine. Chymotrypsin-like endoproteases break peptide bonds when the carboxyl link is by amino acids with aromatic side groups such as tyrosine, phenylalanine, and tryptophan. Exopeptidases cut single amino acids from the free C or N termini. There may also be dipeptidases that split the peptide bond between two amino acids. In this way, large proteins and polypeptides are degraded to free amino acids ready for absorption into the insect body. Finally, let us see how lipids are digested.